Hello, fellow waggers. If you are interested to know how and why I selected the Doberman breed, continue watching this video. If you like our content, please do subscribe to the channel. Now, close to 3 years back, these posters started appearing near my house. Now, this was placed by the local police. They were warning us about this thief who was very, very active during that time. Now, I was really concerned. Why? Because my parents were all alone at my home and I was working in another city. So I decided I can probably opt two options. One is maybe install CCTV cameras or probably choose a guard dog. Now, I decided to opt for the second option, which is choose a guard dog. Now, to do so, I did a lot of analysis and research to understand which breed fits me the most, the qualities of the breed, etc. Now, in this video further, we're going to see the three breeds that I reviewed and how I chose the Doberman breed over the other two breeds. I did extensive research and shortlisted three breeds, the Rottweiler, the German Shepherd, and the Doberman. I understood that these three breeds represent all the qualities that I'm looking for. There are a few minor things that made me choose the Doberman over the German Shepherd and the Rottweiler. The German Shepherd is again an amazing dog, a very good family pet, and an even better guard dog. I just decided that maybe this is not the best fitment for me because of the long hair. I know there are short-haired German Shepherds, but they require constant grooming. And since I was not in the city all the time, I thought my parents would find it difficult to groom the dog every day. And that is the only reason that I decided not to opt for the German Shepherd. What do I say about this amazing breed, the Rottweiler? I'm a hardcore Rottweiler fan myself. I was almost about to get this breed. The only thing that stopped me from probably pursuing it was I thought that maybe the Rottweiler is a bit heavy for my parents to handle. Now, that is the only reason which stopped me, else I would have probably got a Rottweiler. I recommend this dog. It's an amazing breed. It has good qualities in it to be an amazing family pet. And finally, our very own Doberman Pinscher. The following words will explain the qualities of this breed. Athletic, high energy, amazing guard dog, and even amazing, lovable family pet. Now, I selected this breed over the Rottweilers because I thought it might be easy to handle compared to a Rottweiler. Now, honestly, I was wrong. They're equally powerful compared to the Rottweiler, not maybe in size, but in sheer energy, they are really hyper, and it's a handful. When you own a Doberman, it's important that you spend proper time with the dog. You train the dog, discipline the dog, and also very importantly, provide proper exercise. Now, they're full of energy. And if you don't make sure that you don't burn out that energy, the dog can cause problems for you. Now, don't own a Doberman if you don't have time to spend with the dog. Now, I ensured that even if I was not home, the dog was properly exercised. I had friends and family helping me out in that. So every day there were exercise sessions for the dog. So ensure that if you are ready to own this breed, you are also taking responsibility of the things which are supposed to be done. As a Doberman owner, I would say Dobermans are full of passion, love, and energy. And if you are thinking about owning a Doberman, it is that energy that you have to handle. If you channelize that energy properly, if you exercise the dog regularly, and if you're giving that direction to the dog will be an amazing family pet for you. And if you're just going to tie the dog around and not give proper exercise, I'm pretty sure, and take it in writing, the dog will cause problems for you. It's an amazing breed, and if you are thinking about owning it, make sure that you have proper plans to exercise the dog, to groom the dog, and of course, spend proper time with the dog. Now, once you have decided to bring a dog into your life, it's very important to identify the right breed. Now, each breed was bred for a certain purpose and they carry a set of qualities and characters. You need to know what you are getting into. Once you have identified and shortlisted a breed, next you have to shortlist a good breeder. A breeder should have good breeding standards and he should be ethical. Now, if possible, you should also spend some time with the puppy's parents. Now, this will help you have a better picture about the puppy's character and qualities. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I hope it was informative. We'll be back next time with an even better video. Till then, take care and keep wagging.